Hi everyone, welcome you all. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to handle ActionSheets in UI catalog app on iOS device. So let's go to our Mac operating system. So this is my Mac operating system. So the first thing is I need to start my Appium server. So I just launched my Appium server desktop client. And when you click on the start server, so my Appium server is started. So here under inspector session, I have configured my desired capabilities and just I have clicked on this UI inspector. Now it is opening all my desired capability section. So here we need to add all the desired capabilities, and previously I already added some desired capabilities, and here the entry is saved here. So when you select here, you can see platform name, platform version, device name, automation name, and my app location. So currently I'm using iPhone 8. Okay, this is my app location, UI catalog app location. So once you click on the start session, it will go and launch my simulator and where UI catalog app will be installed. Now let's see how we can do this. Now it is trying to, let minimize this one. So it's trying to launch iOS simulator, and then it will try to install the UI catalog app. So now we can see here, it is launching my iOS device. It takes a few seconds of time. So let's wait for a few seconds. Okay, now my simulator is launched, and also it is trying to install UI catalog app. So once it is installed, it will show you all the properties in the UI inspector screen. So my Appium screen will be changed. All right, so my UI catalog app is also installed on my simulator. Now it is also capturing the home screen of UI catalog app. So here we captured the home screen in this particular inspector. So now what we need to do is we need to check action sheet. So here you can see action sheet menu, the first option. So when you click on this action sheet, you will see two options. So what are these action sheet is basically when I click on OK cancel, it will give you two options. You can just click on OK button or cancel button. And similarly, there is other option is there. Click on the other. Now we can click on the destructive choice, or we can say save choice. Okay, we can close this. These are called action sheets. Now let's see how we can handle these things, other as well as destructive choice and save choice. And also we'll see this one. So first of all, what I can do is go back to your UI catalog, UI screen. So we need to click on this action sheets, right? So here, let's identify this element. So before that, let me open my Eclipse. So in my Eclipse, I'm going to create a new class or new test case under this particular package. So go to new class. Now I will name it as example four, and this is action sheets. All right, so now click on finish. Now it is creating a new class. So here I'll just copy some code from my previous example, because desired capabilities are exactly the same. So let me just copy till here. I'm just copying here. And then close this, and here I'm pasting over here. Okay, so now I have just copied my desired capabilities. Okay, so under action sheet, but main method is not there. We have to write a main method. So let me write main method, public static void main. And string args, and inside this main method we need to keep all this code. Okay, so now just import all this required classes, add throws declaration exception, and add this particular class, this is also exception, save it. Okay, add this exception. So now I have just copied some piece of code which is saying like desired capability. So here automation name, platform name is iOS, platform version is 11.4, and this time I'm using iPhone 8 version. So I'm just changing the device name, and app is again same. So the same location my UI catalog app is located. Fine, so till here, and one more thing is we are just clicking on alert view. So instead of this, we need to first click on the action sheets, and then we will get the action sheet. So I'll just change this particular statement now. But before that, let's identify some element here. And let's identify this action sheets. Now, if you see here, accessibility ID is there. So here, let me just properly highlight this action sheets. And let me just click on one more time, Action Sheets. And there is accessibility ID is there. It is saying toolbars, but they're not correct there. So let me just properly highlight this one. So it is activate indicator. And actually it should show Action Sheets here. So it is not properly showing action. It is giving toolbars basically, but that is not the right one. Let's capture correctly. Or else let me just refresh my page. Okay, now I have refreshed my page. I'm getting the fresh UI. So once you get the fresh UI, we need to capture the accessibility ID of the action sheets. Right, so let's try to inspect this element again. So, but again, it is giving toolbar something wrong here, but actually that name should be action sheet, because you can see the other elements like this, we are able to select individual, but here also we should be able to select individual element, and it is selecting both. We need to select properly. Just a second. So let's select action sheet, because it is giving something wrong. This is the UI issue. We can just go and take the access ID is action sheets. Normally, if we just take the other elements, activity indicator, this is accessibility ID, and alert views, this is a alert views is accessibility ID. So similarly, we will also have accessibility ID for this. That is our action sheets. Okay. So we will use that accessibility ID now. So let's go to Eclipse. So in your Eclipse, instead of alert views, I will say accessibility ID is action sheets. Action sheets. And there is a spelling, right? So we need to make sure spelling is correct or not. So action space sheets, right? So here we have a UI error because it is not exactly showing the element action sheet like others. So I'm just directly using action sheets as a accessibility ID. All right, so now let's go to your Eclipse. So now this particular element, driver.findElement by accessibility ID, I specify the action sheet dot click. So this will click on the action sheets. So once you click on the action sheets, then we need to click on one of these options. So I'm just taking this one, other. So let's refresh the screen and check what is the accessibility ID of this other. Now again, refresh your screen. So once you're refreshed, now we will get the fresh screen. So here other is there. Let me inspect this other. So once you click on this other, now you can see accessibility ID is other. Now go to your Eclipse again. So after clicking on action sheets, then here again, I'm using same accessibility ID, driver dot find element by accessibility ID. And here the accessibility ID is other. Okay, so the accessibility ID is other. So other dot click. So I'm just performing the click action. So once you click on this other, now you will see the accessible. This is a actual action sheet. So destructive choice and saves choice. So now I want to click on destructive choice. This is the first option I want to click. So again, refresh your screen and get the accessibility ID of the destructive choice. Now again, refresh this page. And once you're refreshed, now we will get the destructive choice and save choice. I'll show you both the things, destructive choice and save choice. Let us capture the accessibility ID of these two. Fine, so now we got this one. Then we need to again inspect this destructive choice. And for accessibility ID is a destructive choice. And for the save choice, it is again accessibility ID is a save choice. Same thing, we can use it. So for now, I'm just using save choice, and later I will select destructive choice also. So let me just copy this particular accessibility ID. Now go to your Eclipse. Now after that, I'm trying to find again the same element, find driver dot find element by accessibility ID. And here the accessibility ID I'm pasting over here, save choice and dot click. So this will go and click on this particular save choice. And again, it will come back. So what I can do is here, I can see very clearly, because when I put some thread.sleep command, because it will go very faster, we cannot see whether it's clicking properly or not. So I will just say 3000 milliseconds so that we can clearly see that. Fine. So now find accessibility ID CF choice dot click method we have used. And after that, so once you click on this, so again, I will try to click on one more time on the other. So I'm just copying this particular statement one more time. And after that, and again, it will go to the same screen. Now this time I will click on the destructive choice, right? So let's capture the accessibility ID of the destructive choice. Let's inspect this element. And this is your accessibility ID of the destructive choice. So let me just copy this one and go to your Eclipse. So again, specify the same thing. So driver dot find element by accessibility ID, and in the double quotation specify the accessibility ID and dot click. So this will perform the click, and here again I'll put thread dot sleep to see clearly what it is exactly doing. So I'll say 3000 milliseconds, and after that again 3 seconds I'm waiting, and after that I'm just closing the driver. So driver dot close, right? So now save it course. So first what I have done is I clicked on the action sheets. So the first thing is, as soon as UI catalog app is open. So first of all, as soon as UI catalog app is open, I click on the action sheets. So after that, I click on the other. And after that, I click on the save choice and it will closed. Again, I click on the other. And this time I click on the destructive choice. So different operations I have done. So now let's execute and see how this will work. So I'm putting the home page as usual. So now I'm executing our code. So right click, run as Java application. So now we can observe. So first of all, it will install UI catalog app and then it will perform the actions. So now it is trying to install UI catalog app on my simulator. Right, so now we can see it is installed UI catalog app, and it's click on other, then it will click on save choice. It is closed, and again one more time click on other. Now this time it will use destructive choice, and after that driver dot close. Right, so this is how we need to write our script. So here it is giving unknown error. We can just ignore this one. Only thing is we need to use driver dot quit command here. Okay, let me run one more time. This time I'll use driver dot quit command because it will just close the driver. And save the code. Just increases some time out, let's say 5 here. And again, one more time, execute our code. Save it and then run as Java application. So now I have run my code. And then it will go and install UI app, UI catalog app one more time. Now it is trying to install. And after that, it will go and open the UI catalog app. So once it is open, then it is going to click on action sheets and then click on other, then click on save choice. That's the next action. Then again, click on other restrictive choice. Fine, so after that, our program will be exited. Okay, done. So this is how we need to automate the action sheets, guys. So everything is same, just we need to use the accessibility IDs if available, or if we can go for XPath of those elements. It's a simple flow, okay? So this is all about action sheets. In the next video, we'll see a few more elements. That's all for this video, guys. Thanks for watching.